The Second Book of the Kings, Chapter 1. Moab rebelled against Israel after the death of Ahab. Now Ahaziah fell through the lattice of his upper room in Samaria and was injured. So he sent messengers and said to them,
"Go, inquire of Beelzebub, the god of Ekron, whether I shall recover from this injury."
But the angel of the Lord said to Elijah the Tishbite, "Arise, go up to meet the messengers of the king of Samaria and say to them, 'Is it because there is no God in Israel that you are going to inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron? Now therefore, thus says the Lord, you shall not come down from the bed to which you have gone up, but you shall surely die.'" So Elijah departed. And when the messengers returned to him, he said to them,
"Why have you come back?"
So they said to him,
"A man came up to meet us and said to us, 'Go, return to the king who sent you, and say to him, thus says the Lord, is it because there is no God in Israel that you are sending to inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron?
Therefore you shall not come down from the bed to which you have gone up, but you shall surely die.'"
Then he said to them,
"What kind of man was it who came up to meet you and told you these words?"
So they answered him,
"A hairy man wearing a leather belt around his waist."
And he said,
"It is Elijah the Tishbite."
Then the king sent to him a captain of 50 with his 50 men. So he went up to him, and there he was sitting on the top of a hill, and he spoke to him,
"Man of God, the king has said, come down."
So Elijah answered and said to the captain of 50,
"If I am a man of God, then let fire come down from heaven and consume you and your 50 men."
And fire came down from heaven and consumed him and his 50. Then he sent to him another captain of 50 with his 50 men. And he answered and said to him,
"Man of God, thus has the king said, come down quickly."
So Elijah answered and said to them,
"If I am a man of God, let fire come down from heaven and consume you and your 50 men."
And the fire of God came down from heaven and consumed him and his 50. Again he sent a third captain of 50 with his 50 men. And the third captain of 50 went up and came and fell on his knees before Elijah and pleaded with him and said to him,
"Man of God, please let my life and the life of these 50 servants of yours be precious in your sight."
"Look, fire has come down from heaven and burned up the first two captains of 50s with their 50s. But let my life now be precious in your sight."
And the angel of the Lord said to Elijah, "Go down with him. Do not be afraid of him." So he arose and went down with him to the king. Then he said to him,
"Thus says the Lord, because you have sent messengers to inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron, is it because there is no god in Israel to inquire of his word? Therefore you shall not come down from the bed to which you have gone up, but you shall surely die."
So Ahaziah died according to the word of the Lord which Elijah had spoken. Because he had no son, Jehoram became king in his place, in the second year of Jehoram, the son of Jehoshaphat, king of Judah. Now the rest of the acts of Ahaziah, which he did, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the kings of Israel?